Hi everyone, thanks for joining me. I'm Juliana with the Zakim Center, and this is Chair Yoga Flow. So we're going to be seated on our chair most of the time, and some of you, even when we get out of the chair to come back, if that bothers you, if there's anything going on with your body, just that kind reminder to really take care of yourself. If you feel that it's better for you to remain seated and work from there, please do. Really honor your body where it is today. That's the most important thing. And again, you're going to move with your own range of motion, your own limitations, whatever is going on with your body. Really listen to it, be aware, and just try to be kind to yourself. So we're going to move back to the chair, and I'm going to start massaging the feet. So you're going to take that ball on the bottom of your foot, and we're going to start massaging with that. And again, and I know some of you already kind of like reached out and, you know, saying that you're having some things going on with the foot. So if you maybe just taking a gentle massage, maybe even seated and just having the ball under your foot if you need that today. Again, absolutely fine, right? So let's move back to the chair. And I'm gonna take the chair here for my hands, take the ball under my foot. And from here, we're going to start to move. Just make sure that your hand is always supported on something, on a wall, on a counter, any place that you need to. And start pressing firmly into your foot, going to the heel. And as you exhale, gently soften and bring it back to the toes. So firmly pressing and going to the heel. And exhale, softening, coming back to the toes. And do that one more time. And just start to notice awareness, right? Sensations on the bottom of the foot. You start to connect with the breath. And from here, I'm going to keep the ball on the ball of my foot. I'm going to do that little ripping with the toes, spreading them out. And again, going at your own pace, your own range, whatever feels comfortable here. Maybe putting more pressure or less, depending how it feels. Start to feel the arch. Inner arch and outer arch. Right, so this is how your body communicates with you, through sensations, through feelings. So just noticing here what's going on. And just by starting to connect with that, you start to feel that the mind starts to calm down. You start to feel a little bit more present and aware. And that's what we're looking for, right? And just starting to come back to the heel. Just by being more present, the mind starts to let go of all that drama, the anxiety, the stress. That's what we're looking for. That little bit of pause and calm right between the thoughts. And then coming back down here and just noticing right and left. Sometimes you might even see the physical, the arch actually dropping more from one side to the other. We're going to do the same thing to the other side. As you start to press firmly, pressing, going to the heel. And as you exhale, softening, coming back to the toes. Start to connect, breath and the movement. Inhaling and exhaling. And then slowly start to do the little exploration with the toes, right? The ball of the foot. And again, everything is an exploration, right? You always have room to explore, to notice a little bit more. How does this side feel compared with the other? I know for myself that this is the side in my lower body that feels a little tighter, while the right side and right arm is on the upper body is the one that feels a little tighter, right? So there's ways that the body works. Everything is connected, fascia, functional lines of movement, and start to move. Noticing again, so to get closer to that heel and perhaps climbing up a little bit taller, higher up. How does that feel? And then from here, we're gonna release back down, noticing the right and the left. All right, we're gonna find our seat. So take yourself onto your chair and just making sure your toes, your feet are feeling fully supported, grounded, so you can let go completely. Feeling the back being supported by the chair, the sit bones feeling firm and heavily here, sinking into it. And allowing the hands to rest in your lap. Take a nice deep breath through your nose. And a big sigh through the mouth, let it go. One more cleansing breath, inhaling through the nose. And a big sigh through the mouth. Just feeling all the tension and stress just melting away. Allowing your body to feel fully supported by the chair, the earth holding you up, your feet rooting down, grounding. This connection with the earth element brings a sense of well-being, of safety, of belonging. Helps with fear and anxiety. Knowing that this is your safe place so you can let go. The chair supports the sit bones so you can soften to the legs even more. And the chair also helps to lengthen your spine. You feel the entire body fully stacked, the head resting over the heart, heart resting over the hips. So you can soften even deeper. The muscles of your face, corners of your eyes, the jaw, the shoulders, relax, the elbows, fingertips. Noticing the belly soft. So in the stillness of your body, start to find the movement of the breath. Just following it. The inhaling expanding and rising. And the exhale softening, releasing and letting go. Inhale. And exhale. Perhaps even allowing one hand to rest on the belly. Rising and fall. Inhaling, expanding, fingers might spread apart. And exhale, soften. And just by drawing the awareness to the breath, will help you to calm the mind. The breath starts to get longer and deeper. You don't even have to force anything. It just naturally happens. And those longer exhales helps to calm. The mind follows. Noticing how the mind is most likely quieter than when you started. Whenever you feel there's too much going on, allow yourself to come back to the breath so you can find that little bit of pause between your thoughts, that silence that's always there in the background. And in that pause, you can take that deeper breath and make better decisions, better reactions, and feel better. So with your next inhale, allow your hands to come to your heart, one over the other, and breathe into your chest. Breathe in the gratitude of being here today, of taking time from your busy schedule to take care of yourself. With kindness, curiosity, and no judgment. Anything else you're grateful for, breathe it in. Setting up the intention for your practice today. What is your heart's deepest longing? And as you exhale, just bowing your head to your heart, releasing your hands down to your thighs. And as you inhale, start to roll your shoulders up and back and coming to the center of your chair. I'm going to take a block here and bring it between my inner legs just to add a little bit more of engagement of the legs, the pelvic floor, the core. And inhaling, letting your shoulders reach up. And as you exhale, softening down the back. The inhalation lifts. The exhalation releases. Perhaps you're taking your fingertips to your shoulders, elbows up, side and down. As you can turn, continue to circle to open with your next inhale, finding that lift. And as you exhale, release your arms down, drop your chin into your chest. Inhale, roll your left ear to your left shoulder. And as you exhale, roll your chin into your chest, roll the right ear to the right shoulder. To soften the neck, the shoulders. Once again, coming over to the left. Perhaps taking the right arm a little bit higher up. Play with the angle of the head as you look down, side and up. Palm can go up. And then slowly lowering that palm, changing the angle of the arm, changing the neck, the angle of the neck, I should say. Just moving it around. And then as you exhale, roll your chin into your chest, take it to the other side. Inhale, perhaps you take that left arm out, turning the thumb up, palm up. And playing with the angle of the head as you look down, it might feel a little bit more in the back. Ear to shoulder might feel more to the side, nose up, more into the jaw in the front. And you can play with the angle of the head and the arm as it starts to lower down. Roll your chin into your chest as you inhale. Allow your fingertips to go up, reach up. And as you exhale, turning your palms out, slowly pushing the air down like thick air. Inhale, gather up like you're gathering all the positive energy and bringing them, those blessings, down to your heart. Lock the fingers and slowly start to pump up your hands forward. So from the side, it kind of looks like that. You're pushing it out, softening, letting the head drop maybe, and slowly start to look over one shoulder and then the other. So you're also starting to get a little bit of movement through the neck and shoulders. And the pumping also of the elbows and the arms will help with the lymphatic drainage. And so would be the moving of the head onto those lymph nodes into the neck and shoulders, the neck and shoulder area, I should say. And then you start to push it all the way up and then slowly start to find that squeezing of the block and opening here. Now, if it feels too much to extend the arm all the way up, keep it lower. And if it feels too much to keep the fingers locked, you can also release. We're all going to do that releasing of the fingers. Like you're climbing that invisible rope, you're reaching up, picking up. I think this is a season of peaches and nectarines and climbing up all those delicious fruits up. And you're just going to hold it here. And as you exhale, bring that hand behind the head and start just softening the elbow, the shoulder. Perhaps you start to even loosen that arm a little bit more. So you're going to go at your own range. And next time that hand comes behind your head, find a little bit more opening in the heart, the side body, the kidney line. And just like you're admiring that beautiful painting up into the ceiling, looking up, revolving the chest more if you can. As you exhale, let your head be guided to the side. Relax the shoulders. Looking down to your armpit and then release that arm across. Holding here, stretching the deltoids, the shoulders, a little bit of the back. You start to look over the shoulder and then look over your fingers, wiggle the fingers, move it around. I'm going to let that left hand come to the shoulder and you're going to give it a little gentle massage here into the back of the skull, into the side of the neck. And this is the area of the side of the neck here. You have those lymph nodes helping with your immune system, giving a little squeeze. And then you're going to take the other hand under, right under the left. So you're coming into your eagle arms. You start to do a little bit more of a twist. And our focus this week has been twists, which are energizing, helps with digestion, circulation, immune system, helps to move things in the body and release. Right. So back of the hands might come together, and even the front. And we're going to look over the shoulder, come back to the center and to the other side. As you inhale, let your elbows perhaps reach up a little bit more. And as you exhale, pull those elbows and release your hands to your thighs. And finding a little bit of a cat and cow flow here, softening it out. With the inhalation, you slide the hands on your thighs, you open the chest, you squeeze your elbows a little bit more. And as you exhale, you round it again. And again, just being gentle with those roundings and the flat back, back and forth, just in case if you have lower back issues, sciatic pain, right? Your hinges are going to be smaller. And with your next inhale, you're going to allow your arms to reach up again, and you start to climb again, or start to picking up those fruits. The next time you're over to the left, you're going to stay there and come to the chair, and you start to circle. And again, it could just be the shoulder, it could be the elbow, or maybe you start to loosen up that arm a little bit more. And just be, again, exploring what feels good here. Bring that hand behind the head and allow the elbow to lift and open back, and the chest starts to open, maybe spiraling up and maybe looking up into the side. So you're getting more into the front of that armpit, the chest, the side body. With your next exhale, let your head be guided to the side. Relax the shoulders. Looking down to your armpit, sweep that arm across. Now you're going to hold above or below the elbow, and you look over the shoulder, feeling that stretch of the arm. Down to the fingers, you look to the fingers, you wiggle the fingers, roll the wrist. And then allow that hand to come to the shoulder, and giving a massage again to the back of the skull, the side of the neck. Give it a little squeeze, give it some love, right? And then slowly let the other elbow come under, and you start to find that hugging, that squeezing. There's a lot of that into the twist. It's like a sponge. You rinse it, and then when you soak it, you release that stretch. It opens and soaks it, feeling that movement and opening. Inhale, maybe taking the gaze over one side and maybe to the other. Take the elbows up. Next time you exhale, release your hands once again, bring it back to your knees, finding that opening of the heart and rounding of the spine. Inhaling and exhaling. And now we're going to start to circle it, just getting a little bit more through the side body. And then take it the other way. Nicely done. Come back to the center. Inhale, arms come up. Finding your cactus, your goddess arm. So if you look to the back of the elbows, the hands, they're like almost like they're flat against the wall behind you. Lift into the chest. And as you exhale, tip it over. Inhale back to the center and exhale to the other side. We're going to do that two more times. Come back to the center and tip it over to the right. Working the side body, one side contracts, the other one straightens, stretches, and take it back. Inhale. And now from here, as you exhale, pull the tips of your shoulder blades together. Elbows come in closer to the waist. Feel the opening of the heart. Inhale, take it back to the center. And as you exhale, you close. Now you're spreading to those shoulder blades. Inhale, exhale. Elbows come in, heart opens, chest opens. And then as you exhale, slowly close. Now let's combine both. Inhale here, let's tip it over to the right. Come back to the center, pull the tips of the shoulder blades together, elbows into the waist. Inhale, center. Exhale, close. Inhale, center, tip it over to the left this time. Come back to the center. And exhale, staying here. Now let the elbows bend a little bit more. And think about the hands going back just a little and squeeze and open. Last two, last one, the arms come down. Turn your palms up to the sky. And like you're carrying a tray, it opens and squeeze back. Two more. Engaging those rotator cuffs, the back there. And then holding it here, palms faces each other. Take it back like you're opening again the door and you close. Last time through. Hold it here, take your arms all the way up, inhaling. Exhale, pull those elbows again. And this time you're gonna twist. We're gonna take that left elbow over to the right. Inhale, come back to the center. Take the right over to the left. Inhale, back to the center. And this time we're gonna exhale and twist the entire thing over, release the arms. Inhale, find a lift through the spine. As you exhale, revolve your shoulders slightly back. Now try to keep your head aligned with your sternum, which front of the chest there. Inhale, lengthen. And as you exhale, revolve that shoulder perhaps back. Maybe the hands will slide further back. So maybe you start to hear, maybe it starts to come back and coming back. The last part of this twist is the neck, the cervical spine. So maybe the head will go slightly back. Now from here, we're going to release and letting that right hand come up and over. Now feel like almost like your hands are going to go in opposite directions. Reach and open, maybe again, gazing under and up. As you exhale, release. Let the arms come back again into your eagle arms, finding that little squeeze and hugging of the twist. Maybe the elbows, inhale, lift. Exhale, pull your elbows into the belly. Maybe a slight hinge. Inhale, let your arms reach up to the sky. Exhale, finding your cactus. Beautiful work. We're going to flow and twist to the other side. Release your hands. Inhale, lengthen through the spine. Exhale, soften and revolve the shoulders slightly back. Again, inhale, lengthen. And exhale, perhaps you go a little deeper. Find your breath. With the inhalation, you lift. With the exhalation, you soften and go deeper. Now keep your right hand where it is. Inhale, let your left arm reach up and over. Exhale, maybe pushing a little deeper, going stronger through the side, maybe even revolving and looking up. As you exhale, soften and release, let the arms come together, holding onto the shoulders. You can stay, again, with the hands on the shoulders or letting the backs or front of the hands. Inhale, find a little bit more lift here. Hands away as you exhale, pull those elbows in. A hinge from your hips as you release your arms down. Inhale, open the heart. Let the hands come slightly behind. I'm going to turn it around so you can see. Maybe squeezing your elbows and finding that lifting of the sternum, the chest up. Modify camel. And as you exhale, slowly soften and let it go. Nice work. We're going to slowly drop that hands down. We're going to bring the hands together. And we're going to find a little bit more release into the wrist. Start to play with this here. Try to relax your shoulders and try it the other way. All right. It's usually one side that feels odd when you do that, right? Okay. And then from here, we're going to start to take the massage onto the heel of our palms. And this is a good practice for arthritis, also neuropathy on the hands. And you can be gentle, right? If there's any spot that's calling your attention that you want to stay there a little bit longer, you can absolutely do that. You can always revisit. And I'm just giving you a suggestion like anything else, right? You really listen to your body. I'm squeezing my fingers all the way up to the tips of those nails, finger by finger. And then on this one, I kind of like to pinch the webs of the fingers, pinch, hold, and release. Also getting all these really nice acupressure points in your hands. Just like we did with the ball, in this case, we're using our hands instead. And if by any chance you have one of those smaller balls that you like to play with your hands instead, you can always do that as well. And then let it go. And just noticing the right and the left, right? We're going to do the same thing on the other side. So starting with the heel and you start to move it up. Face, noticing the sensations there. Start to go a little bit higher. And then start to, again, finding that squeezing of the fingers, you start to move it up all the way to the tip and to the nail. Excellent work, guys. And then play with that pinching on the webs of the fingers. Pinch, hold, and release. Pinch, hold, and release. As you move from web to web, just noticing the sensation. It's usually one or another that feels a little bit more odd, right? And then let it go. Excellent work. So I'm going to drop that block. I'm going to move my chair slightly back. Now, at any point, if you feel that you need to get water, hydrate, please do. So I'm just going to take my strap to the side. Now I'm going to start to add a little bit moving with the feet. So now I'm starting to engage my core a little bit more. Think about the hands on being supported on the thighs. Every time you lift that leg, you're feeling that the muscles under your hands are contracting to lift it up, keeping that spine nice and tall, core engaged, lower back supporting you. Now I'm going to hold my left leg up. Hold it here, bend and extend that knee. So You start to get into the knee joint. Now you start to get into the hamstring. Point the toes and flex the foot like you're gonna drag a sheet of paper under. One more. Hold it out there. Put a point and flex of the toe, roll the ankle. And point and flex and roll it the other way. Hold it up, a little pulsing up for 3, 2, and 1, drop it down. Inhale, lengthen your spine. Now all the weight is going to be on that bent leg. As you exhale, you're going to hinge from your hips. You can even bring your hands to the creases of your hips to notice where it is. Your spine is going to stay nice and long. Sciatic pain, lower back issues, we're going to just be careful here when you forward fold. That knee is soft. You're not locking the knee, you're softening the knee. If by any chance you want to go deeper, you don't need the strap to go deeper, but if you like, you can take that strap up and over the foot and walk it further down, right? Now, your gaze is going to be down to the floor, the foot slightly ahead of you. So the back of your neck is nice and long in alignment with your spine, so you're not looking up. You're not putting strain on the neck. Engage the core. And now from here, I'm going to bring that block, the strap in the same hand, and bring my body up, engaging the core, bending the knee, and now I'm going to get into that hip socket. So I'm starting to open and close. Just juicing up into the hips, noticing here. If you don't like the strap under the foot, you can put the strap under your thigh. It's just to assist you. The foot is just hovering. Maybe you start to take it a little deeper and going further out. No right or wrong, right? It's what feels good for you. Allow that little moving of the leg to one side and then to the other. And then bring it back to the center. Take your time. Switch the hands, soften the knees. Now from here, inhale, lengthen your spine. As you exhale, turn your toes slightly to the side, crest to the heel, and start to feel the twist from the shoulder crossing to the side body down to the foot. Inhale, lift it a little bit more. Exhale, revolve. Beautiful. Now maybe staying here, and with your next exhale, crossing the ankles. So we're going to combine this. I'm going to take that strap and just put it on my hips. Maybe this is going to be how you're going to stay with your eagle legs. Maybe you can cross one knee on top of the other. So finding again that squeezing of the legs, the engaging of the core, lifting of the spine. When you feel ready, inhale, let your wings open. And as you exhale, you're going to take your left under the right. Once again, finding that hugging, the lifting. Any choice here, staying here, back or front. Feel that your hands can move a little away from your face or your elbows for that matter. Keep the shoulders down, inhaling. As you exhale, perhaps you nest your eagle. Spine is long, you start to hinge just a little bit and you release. Lifting up, maybe you start to feel it onto your hips or lower back. So if you feel that this is too much, cross to the ankles. If you want to get more, start to maybe slide that ankle closer to your knee and hinge, or maybe even letting that knee drop into your figure four. Noticing the sensations on the outer hips, the knees. If this bothers your knees or your hips, back off, right? If you have access to your foot, you're so close there, give it a little massage. Start to press it onto that big toe mound and that imaginary line of the kidney line. It goes through the inner arch between that bony part of your ankle to your heel. You continue to trace it up in that inseam of your pants there, all the way up to your knee. And then from the knee to your groin. And if you can't reach your foot, you can still do maybe the knee to the groin. And then release it out, give it a little tap. Noticing the right and the left. All right, we're gonna do the same thing on the other side. So from here, start to find that little bit of a march. Shoulders are relaxed. All right, we're gonna hold that leg, the right leg up, bend. Hands can be closer to the chair. Point the toes, flex the foot. Point the toes, flex the foot. Last one, hold it up there. Pulse, 3, 2, 1, and release it down. Engage and hinge from the hips. Start to fold. Weight is onto the bent leg. The other leg is soft, knee is soft. If you wanna go deeper, and if you feel like it, flex the foot, curl your toes in the direction of your head. Perhaps you walk a little bit more down. Again, spine is long. Knee is soft. Back of the skull is aligned with your spine. Gaze to the floor slightly ahead of that foot. Take one more breath in. With your next exhale, hold the strap with the same hand. Bend the knee and start to open and close. So I'm just gonna turn my body to face forward, if that maybe you'll be able to see a little bit better. But it's just floating. And then maybe you start to take it a little bit wider, longer, extending the leg. It doesn't have to, right? The range of motion on this side might feel very different on this side. So maybe this side you're just smaller. Maybe you're wider. Wherever you are, we're gonna slowly give a little circle. Other side, and we're gonna bring it back to the center. Switch the hands, relax the shoulders. Now think about crossing your toes, slightly pigeon toes, so the toes turn a little bit more to the left, you press with your right heel. Inhale, lengthen your spine, combine the twist from your shoulders, revolving back, side body, twisting down through the side hips, the legs, IT bend, that fascia on the outside of your leg here, stretching, slightly pigeon-toed. As you exhale, release, come back to the center, let the ankle cross. I'm gonna take the strap out of the way. So maybe this is where you're gonna stay. Maybe you start to bring the knee on top, finding that little eagle hugging of the legs, core engaged, lower back engaged. Inhale, let your wings open. This time as you exhale, it's the right that comes under the left. You give yourselves a hug once again. Elbows can go up, staying here, or back so the hands are front. Keep the shoulders down, the elbows maybe out and the hands maybe away from you. Take one more breath in. And as you exhale, perhaps your hands from your hips, you start to unwind. Inhale, take your arms all the way up. And exhale, slowly finding those knees, maybe staying here and hinging, maybe taking that ankle, maybe dropping the knee away, finding your version of figure four, right? This side again might feel very different. And again, if you have access to your foot, give it a little love here. Pressing into that kidney line, bubbly spring point, that's what it's called, that in the big toe and the, what is that called, second finger, first finger, I should say. And you give it a little squeeze up into that inseam of your pants, moving it up. And continue all the way to your groin. And then when you're ready, we're gonna let it go. Give it a little tap, moving it side to side. So again, we're working a little bit more with twists this week. So we're gonna continue with that theme. I'm gonna add one more twist here onto the chair. I'm gonna turn my chair sideways so you can see, perhaps grabbing that block. Bring the block between your legs, if you like. Now I'm kind of like in the middle of the chair here. So I have some support and one kind of like, yeah, in the middle. So it's a common that when you twist that one knee is gonna try to sneak in front of the other. So I'm gonna twist to your left. And so from here, I'm gonna inhale, take my arms up. And as I exhale, I'm gonna release them to the back of the chair. Now try it again. We're twisting from the thoracic spine up. From the waist down, you wanna stay still. So as you inhale, find a lift in your spine. Now, as you exhale, you're gonna push with the back hand and pull with the front. So you push with the left, pull with the right, and you start to turn your chest a little bit more. Think about length. Inhale, lift, and exhale, perhaps push and pull and revolve a little bit more. So this is a great twist to do if you stay seated very long, right? Because it really helps to release tension in the lower back, move things around. And with your next exhale, soften and release. Let's try it on the other side. So I'm gonna turn my chair around so you'll be able to see it better. Find that support that you need. Feet are grounded, knees are parallel. So you know there's a tendency of twisting around, right? So you want to keep it back. So engage, squeeze, give it a hug. Now from here, when you feel ready, inhale, let your arms reach. And as you exhale, let them land in the back of your chair. So inhale, lengthen your spine, keep that length. Push with the back hand, pull with the front. Inhale, length. Exhale, push with the back, pull with the front, twist. Keep that length, one more. Exhale. Release it back, inhale. And release, great job. Since we have the block here, we're gonna start to add a little bit more. I'm gonna squeeze the block to hug it in. I start to feel that hugging of the block, the engagement here. And maybe you start to take your heel, weight back to the heels and release. And again, you can stay with the hands on the chair, or you can start to cross your hands in front of your shoulders. Take one more. And exhale. Take your arms all the way up. Release that block from between your legs, heel toe your feet. So we worked on engaging the inner legs. Now we're gonna work outside. Don't let the knees drop in. Feel that you're pushing out. Inner legs now are engaging to keep it away. Toes and knees are tracking the same direction. Take your arms up into your goddess cactus arms. And we're gonna tip it over to the right. Working again, you're contracting on one side and stretching on the other. Inhale, come back to the center and to the other side. Lower back is stabilizing, inner legs are engaging. Next time you're over to the right, we're gonna stay to the right, hold it here. Hand's gonna come behind the head, and now that's that twist again. This time you're a little warmer, deeper. Feel that opening a little bit more. Maybe the arm will even go further back. And as you exhale, start to bring that elbow down, point down, you come to the center. Let the right hand stay on the thigh. Let the left hand come to your thigh. And start to feel your chest moving away. So you start to get a little bit more opening through the side, revolving of the chest, maybe staying here. We're taking that right hand to the hip, revolve the right shoulder back. Some of you might even take that arm up and over the head. And then slowly come back to the center. You're gonna cross your arms and elbows, finding your goddess again, stay strong. And as you exhale, you're gonna tip it over to the left. This time the hand, forearm comes down, the elbow, hand comes behind the head, elbow starts to open, open. Maybe the arm will even reach back. And as you exhale, point the elbow back down. And then you start to reach and counter twist. You start to bring the hands to the other side. Moving your chest away. Start to find the opening through the side body. Maybe your left hand comes to your hip, your shoulder revolves slightly back. And then maybe you take that arm up and over like an extended side angle variation here. And then slowly release. Let your arms come back up. Exhale, heel toe your feet again, bring it down. Roll your shoulders up and back. Taking the block or no block between your legs, your choice. Hands onto the shoulders or onto the chair. Slow and control, come up for 3, 2, and 1. Inhaling and exhaling, releasing. We're gonna move to the back of the chair. Finding your flow here as you step back and you're down dog and you pedal and you move it around. Beautiful work. Now, if you feel uncomfortable coming up today, you can always stay on your chair. And again, finding the stretch onto the back of the legs, just like to slide that foot, the left foot forward, pressing through the right heel, and you pump that heel. And then you bring your hands back up and you support the hands on the chair. You drop your tail and you let your body sink down here. Feel the opening. If you're seated on your chair, your twist will be right here, right? So noticing it's the same thing, you're dropping the tail. Take one more breath in. And as we're working with twists, I want to challenge you today. maybe bringing your left hand to your heart and your twist, and you start to open that arm back. As you exhale, release it back down, drop to your heel, open your arm out to the side. You're coming into your warrior two, and you, again, you can always stay seated and just open the arms and maybe extending to that front heel and reaching up, finding your flow. Release your hands to the chair and coming again into that version of extended side angle, revolving the shoulder, noticing how this is an open twist. And then slowly letting that hand pull you back, warrior two. As you exhale, hands to the chair and you flow into your down dog or puppy on the chair. So noticing the stretch from the arms, the side body, down the spine, the hips, the legs. And I'm just going to turn the chair around so you might be able to see it better. And this time it's the right foot that goes forward, back heel continues to pump. Soften. And then taking you into your crescent lunge with the back knee bends a lot. Drop the tail, engage the core, lift the spine, and feeling that opening in the front of the hip flexors. Again, you can always do this seated on your chair as well. And this is a really great stretch for if you stay seated very long, opening it up. And just because we're working with twists, taking your right hand to your heart, maybe you start to twist your chest to that bent knee and then reaching it back. Exhale, unwind, bring that hand down. Drop the back heel, again, being aware that the front knee doesn't pass the toes. Reaching it up, and if you don't need the chair, let go of the chair, turn the palms, reach up, lift up. Peaceful warrior, finding your flow, exhale. And then letting that hand come back to the chair, hands to the hip, revolving and opening the chest to shoulders. Staying here, or some of you might even take that arm all the way up. Whatever works for you. The lengthening to the side body, you bring yourself back up. And as you exhale, very gently come all the way up, back. And we're just going to take this out into that version that we did of eagle pose. So we're going to have the hand on the chair. I'm going to soften the knees. And I'm going to take the outside leg, left leg, and cross it in front. I'm going to squeeze those legs together, bend the knees, and squeeze. The chest is lifted, the tailbone sitting back. So from the side, it kind of looks like you're doing a chair, like you're sitting back onto the chair. Weight is back onto that right heel. Taking the hand to the heart. Maybe your sit bones are even supported on a wall behind you. And you can let that hand cross your shoulders like you did with your eagle. And if you want to play with your balance and maybe you take the other arm under, right? You can choose. If you exhale, you're going to unwind or keeping that hand on the chair and switch it. So this is a really powerful one for the legs that squeeze, the core compacts. And we're going to take it to the other side. I'm just going to change the blocks instead of moving the chair. So you cross. Hugging the knees, engaging, navel's pulling in, lower back is supporting, hips are compacting. Again, it's all about that eagle and the twist that you're really rinsing, and then you're going to soak and let it expand. So finding that rinse, that hint, and maybe you take your other hand, I just didn't change the chair, and you can take one hand to the shoulder, maybe both, right? Maybe starts to lift if you want to sink more into that heel. Squeeze your knees even more. The backs of the hands or the front can always come together. And then slowly release. Inhaling. And exhaling. Let's find our chair, our seat, to close our practice. And just a nice way to focus and bring in that awareness in. We're going to do Brahmati breath. So it's basically you're just going to inhale and exhale through your nose. Your lips are going to be closed and soft. And every time you exhale, you're going to make that like a humming sound. All right. So this is what it's going to sound. You can even close your eyes, inhaling through the nose and exhaling through the nose. We're going to do that three times, inhaling and exhaling. On your own, you can even cover your eyes, cover your ears. After you finish your third, relax your hands back down, keeping your eyes closed and just feeling for the echo of your practice. And this breath helps with inflammations in the nasal passages, the sinuses. Also helps calming and centering. Feel the muscles in your face once again relaxing. The ears rolling inwards and down. Softening the jaw. Relaxing the tongue. The shoulders. The elbows. The fingertips. Noticing the heart lights. The belly soft. The hips releasing into the chair. As you continue to relax down the legs, the knees, all the way to your toes. You're happy where you are, you can stay where you are. But if you feel like moving, start to wiggle your fingers, your toes, deepening your breath. And then bring your palms together into Anjali Mudra prayer pose. Bring your thumbs to your forehead, remembering the light and gratitude that you brought into your practice. And carrying it with you even brighter. Bow the head to the heart. Namaste. The light in me bows to the light in you. Thank you so much for letting me guide you today. If you have any questions, doubts, feedback, let me know.